Good afternoon to all dear participants. Once again, welcome to this session. And this is our fifth day. And I am happy to see you all continuously attending these sessions. And I hope that the sessions are very useful to you. And now we can continue with Dr. Sabha.
Thank you, sister. Yeah, very good afternoon to one and all, those who are attending this workshop, fifth day workshop on LaTeX. Okay, so today we are going to see how to prepare your book or report and also template of thesis, okay, mathematical content thesis. So also bibliography. It's a very tedious task. We are going to show this very easily, how to add bibliography in our content. So first one, book structure. Preparation of your book or your report is similar to that of an article, what we have seen yesterday. The only difference is that of book or report contains a number of chapters. Okay, but in article, there is no chapter. It starts with only section. In book or report, we have chapters, where each chapter is independent of article. Okay, a book is prepared through the document class book, and a report is prepared through the document class report. The structure of book is, please mute your audio. Okay, the structure of report is similar to that of book, so that we are concentrate only on book, not about report. Okay, so it contains book is divided into three matters. First one is front matter, second one is main matter, third one is back matter. Front matter command covers the cover, title, empty page title, information about copyright, ISBN, and so on, dedication if any, or else it's empty, table of contents, list of figures. It can be added in back matter also. Okay, next one, preface chapter. So these things are called front matter. So next one, we are going to say main matter. Main matter is our content. So then back matter. Back matter includes bibliography, appendix if any, glossary or in-text. Okay, these are appeared in back matter. So basic template of book. Okay, I'm going to show basic template. Usually it gives once, it's a basic template. Okay, it has document class 11 points. As I am creating, this is 11 points. It's an optional bracket. Okay, A for paper. So this is book. Okay, title. It contains me. Okay, title. It's our title of our content. LaTeX, learning by doing. So next one, author. It's my name. So our begin document itself, our content starts here. Okay, front matter. We may include our front matter here. So like a table of contents, cover, title, and so on. Okay, so next one, main title. Whatever it may be, our front matter. So it gives the output by the input file, make title. This command only prints the front matter. Okay, make title. So next one, chapter, preface, table of contents, main matter. So main matter starts with slash chapter. It's my first chapter content. Slash chapter, equation. I'm going to give title. Second chapter title is equation one. Okay, this is second chapter. So back matter, it's a very basic template. So back matter slash appendix. Okay, it gives the appendix. So this command only prints the appendix, otherwise it won't print that content, chapter appendix. So next one, bibliography style. There's many. So after the last session, we are going to see about bibliography. So lot of styles are available. I am using plain style here, bibliography style, plain. So next one, slash bibliography. I am going to include my bibliography as my bib. Okay, dot bib file. Okay, not an text file. I am going to insert the bib file. This is the basic template. Okay. So next we are going to see these few things about this one. Yeah. Here, table of contents. Table of contents prints only the numbered section. Prints only the numbered section. It won't print the unnumbered section. That means if you put star here, slash chapter star, means it won't print the title in our table of contents. It only prints numbered section and also numbered equation likewise. Okay, Okay, so here it's mathematical thesis preparation in Tamil. I made one video in Tamil language. So now I am going to explain the thesis preparation template for mathematical students. Okay, so yes, it's my template for preparation. Now it's visible. TechMaker is visible. Anyone, please? TechMaker is visible or not?
Yes, TechMaker is
visible. Okay. I am going to use this template for creating thesis, mathematical content thesis. I am going to explain one by line by line. So first one is document class. Okay, first one is document class. I am creating my thesis with the 12 font size. Okay, with the 12 font size, 2-sided. I want to print my thesis in 2-sided so that I made this command 2-sided. Okay, it's based on Bharadasan University Trichy. Okay, this template based on Bharadasan University Trichy. I am creating my thesis in the document class book. I am going to use this book. So next one, I am using the package geometry. Okay, for that margin purpose. Okay, for that margin purpose, I am using that geometry package. A4, left 1.4. Okay, you may define in some other way. So I am using left margin 1.4 inch, right margin 1 inch, top margin 1.8 inch, bottom margin 1.5. If you want to change this, it's also possible. You may change 1.5 for all margin. Okay, 1.5 for 4 sides. It's also, you may change like this. Okay. So next one, AMS Math. I am using AMS Math package for creating mathematical content. So next, I am using AMS THM. That's for theorem environment. Theorem, corollary, lemma. For that purpose, I am using this one, AMS theorem. So next one, AMS fonts. AMS fonts for mathematical font style. So next, AMS SYMP. That's AMS symbol. That's for simple. Alpha, beta, gamma. And so on, I am going to insert some other symbols regarding mathematical. Okay, next one, I am using graphics package. Graphics for to include graphics, image, figures. Okay, for the purpose, I am using this graphics package. Next one, enumerate for listing items. Enumerate for listing items. We may use, already we have seen numbered list, unnumbered list. Okay, so for the purpose, I am using this enumerate package. Next one is PDF synchronization. Okay, PDF synchronization. It's a little bit complicated. I will tell you later. So next one, hyper reference. Okay, if you are using any hyper link, means it will work only by the package hyper reference. Otherwise, it won't work. Suppose if you are refer some websites or some other journals, we may use hyper reference. Just if you press that link, it automatically opens that content or web page somewhere else. Okay, for the purpose, I am using hyperref package. So site color. Suppose if you want to hyperref with your citation and your content. Okay, that's also possible. Here I made color. Okay, so usually gives a red color. Default it gives a red color. Here I am change that color black site color. That's also possible in optional bracket. Okay, link color is black. So next one. Use package PDF pages. Suppose if you want to insert some PDF pages in your LaTeX document, that's also possible. If you want to insert some PDF pages to your LaTeX document, that's also possible with the help of this package PDF pages. Okay, for the purpose, I am using this one. So next one, allow display breaks. It automatically gives the space between the pages. Okay, for example, suppose if you are preparing a equation at the bottom of that page, but it not compacts with that page, bottom of that page, it automatically goes to the next page. Equation automatically goes to the next page. At the time, before that page, the bottom of the page should be empty. So that I want to avoid those things. That's why I am use this package, allow display breaks. Okay, this command won't give the space between the pages. Okay, it automatically allow the display breaks. So next, these things I used for hype. Suppose if you are having one letter successfully, some one word successfully. Okay, success is one line, fully is next line with the hyphen. Okay, so to avoid those things, I am using these commands. So hyphenality is equal to 1000. So I will explain later hyphenness. Okay, hyph badness. Okay, so these commands avoid the hyphen commands, hyphen words. Okay. So next one, use package numbers. So NatBib is nothing but it's one type of bibliography style. Okay, it's nothing but one type of bibliography style, NatBib. So I want to bibliography in numbers format. Okay, lot of formats are available, book format, handwritten format, like that. So I need number format, so that I am using numbers in optional bracket. This is used for a reference style. Okay, So these things are called preambles. Okay, these things are called preambles. Suppose if you are having this file, no need to worry your formation. Just you have to focus on your content only. It automatically adjusts the size and the chapter title, section title, and so on. Everything will be arranged automatically. Okay, this thing is preamble. Okay, before the begin document, wherever before the begin document, that's all called preamble. So now we are going to enter our main content. So this is begin document. Okay, whatever it may be, you know, within begin document, end document, that's called body. Okay, that's called body. Before that begin document, that's called preamble. Okay, before that, that's called preamble. So here, just now we have seen book divided into three parts: front matter, back matter, main matter, back matter. Okay, here I denote front matter. This command, okay, slash front matter. It concludes on. It describes. Title, cover page, cover of your page, title, certificate, dedication, acknowledgement, up to preface, that things is called front matter. So here I renew that command. Okay, one day before we have seen that command, renew command. So renew command is nothing but its existing command, baseline stretches, existing commands. We are going to renew this command. Okay, baseline stretches automatically. This is nothing but line space. Baseline stretches nothing but line space. Okay. Line space. I need 1.3 line space for my front matter. So that I renew that command 1.3. Okay. So page style is plain. Okay. So there is no fancy head. It does not contain the header, footer, and so on. A plain style means it gives the page number at the bottom center. Okay. That means plain style. So include front. Include front is nothing but my front matter content. That means front page content. I divide into several parts. So my this one. Okay, first line denotes the front page. My front page content. So next one, certificate page. Okay, include certificate page. Next one, dedication. Okay, next one, dedication. So another one, acknowledgement. Okay, I am going to enter. I entered my acknowledgement content in that file. Okay, I will show that files one by one. So first I explain these things. Okay, so next one, I'm going to once again change the lines space. Okay, baseline search 1.4. Okay, I'm going to change the line space for table of contents and list of figures, list of tables. Okay, normal size is nothing but font style. Okay, font size, normal size is nothing but font size. Here normal size is nothing but 12, font size is 12. So next one, list of contents. List of contents prints the table of contents in our documents with numbered section, only numbered section. Okay, it prints the numbered section. Suppose if you have the two long title, you have to enter your shortest title within that optional bracket, square bracket. I will show later. So next one, list of figures. List of figures is nothing but it used to print the list of figures which we have used in our thesis. Okay, a list of table is also print the tables which we have used in our thesis. Next one, slash include notation. Okay, this NOT is nothing but notation. I use this command notation, so it contains the notation page. These things are called front matter. Okay, up to notation we may include preface also. Okay, it's based on university template. Okay, up to this is called front matter. So next I am going to enter into main matter. Okay, main matter starts with our first chapter. Okay, main matter starts with our first chapter. So before that I renew some commands for my satisfaction. Okay, my satisfaction and how to type easiest way in mathematical content in that. So that I renewed some commands. So hereafter I used this line, renew command, baseline stretch, line space is 2. Baseline stretch, line space is 2. So this is hereafter I am going to use the line space 2. Okay, so next one, new theorem style. Okay, theorem style is also the, so I renew that command, new theorem style THM. I defined THM. Theorem environment is already defaultly available in LaTeX. I am going to renew that command. Okay, new theorem style THM. It has 9 arguments. So 9 arguments base. First break denotes the theorem style. Okay, theorem style. So second break, this second one. Okay, this line denotes the second argument brace denotes the space above that content. Space above that content. This third line. Okay, baseline skip. This third argument denotes the space below that theorem. Space below that theorem. This one, fourth one, denotes slash SL shape. That's nothing but slanting shape. text size, okay, text font, slanting shape. That's nothing but body font. Okay, theorem content, body font. So next one. So this empty mandatory bracket denotes the space insert. It automatically gives the one space. Okay, one space. This denotes the space between the theorem body content and the head font. Body content and the head font. So next one denotes this BF series denotes the theorem font. Okay, head font. So suppose I want to theorem in bold size. Okay, that means I am using this one BF series. So next one punctuation mark between the body content and the head content. So theorem, after that I need that dot. Suppose if you want to get semicolon or comma, whatever it may be, you may use here. I am using dot. So next one, this is head space above and below. It has 9 arguments. So I am defining like in this way. Suppose if you want to renew command, that's also possible. Okay, so next one, proof name. It's a default one is slanted shape with the normal. Okay, slanted shape. So but I want in bold serious space. Okay, I want to proof as bold, so that I am making this command slash renew command proof name. Okay, if you want to change the proof name, that's also possible. Proof name, okay, slash proof name. I want to change that name as slash RM is nothing but Roman font style. BF series is nothing but bold face. Proof, I want that renew command, so proof name as proof. Okay, but defaultly it also prints. How it prints means proof only, proof like, sorry, so like that it prints in slanted text only. Okay, but I don't want this much. I need this one bold face, this one. So next one, theorem style. So here after I am denoting that style, my style. Okay, theorem style, I am defining new environment. Okay, new environment, this is called new environment. So I am using slash new theorem. THM denotes the theorem. Okay, suppose if you are typing begin THM, end THM, it prints the theorem. Okay, prints the theorem. This optional bracket, I denote here section. I am using one optional bracket for numbering purpose. Okay, numbering purpose, I am using here section. Suppose if you want to get theorem 1.1, that's nothing but first chapter first theorem. Theorem 1.1 is nothing but theorem first chapter first theorem, new theorem. Next one, I am this is for preparing theorems. So next I am going to make some other commands for definition. I am going to next definition, new theorem slash DFN. DFN is nothing but to make definition. Okay, this is our content, definition. Suppose if you are typing slash DF, begin DFN, end DFN, it prints the definition. Okay, theorem, I am using optional bracket THM here. So for continuation number, if you suppose if you have theorem 1.1, after that if you are using begin definition, end definition, definition number is 1.2. okay, don't worry, I will I will show the demo class also in that content. Okay, next one, I am preparing corollary, corollary. I am using here THM, that's also prefer continuation number. Likewise, I prepared lemma, proposition, example, result, RE denotes a remark, NT denotes note. Suppose it's not easy to you make it as lemma, that's also possible. If you want to rechange that name, that's also possible. Here for my convenient, I am using LEM for lemma. Suppose if you want to give full name lemma, that's also you may use. Okay, so next, renew command, baseline stretch 2. Okay, 2 I am going to use slash include. I am going to include my first chapter here. I am going to include my first chapter here slash include CH1. Okay, it should be prepared in some separate document. Okay, for it's prepared for, suppose I am run this file with chapter 2, chapter 1. It's okay, it gives the output without any error. Okay, I prepared up to 5th chapter without any error. Suppose I made mistakes in chapter 6. If you are running that file, it won't run. Okay, so that I am going to run this file by chapter, so that for that purpose only I am splitting my content in chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3 and so on. Okay, so these things are called main matter. Okay, next we are going to enter in back matter. So for back matter, I am using line space 1.5. we may use this command also, line slash line spread 1.5. it creates the line space 1.5. bibliography style abbreviation. Okay, bibliography style abbreviation. Abbreviation is nothing but it gives the full author name. So yesterday we have seen how to add contents line. Okay. It won't give the content line. Okay. Suppose if you want to add this reference in your table of contents. Suppose if you want to add reference in table of contents, for that we have to add to contents line. Where we have to add DOC. DOC is nothing but table of contents. If you want to add in list of figures, you may change this as LOT, list of table, list of figures. So, but I want this reference in a table of contents. Okay, so that I am using DOC. At what type? Chapter, section, subsection. At what type we have to add? Chapter. I want this reference as a chapter, so that I am making here as chapter. Okay, so this thing is reference. This title is reference. So, pattern section. So yesterday we have seen this command also. Hyper reference won't work if you are using this command slash add contents line. Okay, suppose if you are clicking reference in table of contents, it goes somewhere else, not exact to reference. It goes somewhere else. So that we have to add this command pattern section. Pattern section only gives the exact hyper reference. Okay. So next one, bibliography. So bibliography, we have to prepare bibliography in .zip file. So we have made in some easiest way, but that is not exact way of preparation of reference. Okay, we have to prepare reference in a .zip file. Okay, suppose if you are using LaTeX. Okay, otherwise don't bother about that. If you are using LaTeX, I suggest to prepare your reference file in .zip format. Okay, so include my publication. These are all in PDF pages. Okay, I have shown previously. Include use package PDF pages for that purpose only. I am using that package. Include publication. I am going to include my publication, list of publications PUP. So include PDF. So this is the procedure to include PDF files. So slash include PDF. This is the command pages from which page to which page you have to add. Suppose if you are having 100 pages, okay, 100 pages book. From that page book, you need only. Or 5 pages, okay, only 5 pages from page number 1 to 6 or 1 to 8, whatever it may be, pages. You have to define page number from this to this, 1 to 6. Scale of that book, okay, scale of that page size. So I am using 0.8. And this art is nothing but, I am saving that PDF file in that name art, okay, in that name art. Art means article. I am using short name for art. So end document. This is the simplest way to produce mathematical thesis. Okay, so we are going to see one by one with this help of this content. Okay, so I am going to show this demo file. Okay, just for our time convenient, I am copy this file and also creating new document. Okay, I am saving this file in desktop. So thesis, I save this file as thesis. Okay, as I am going to run this file. So before that, I am blocking these commands, deleting this command, because I don't have these things. So if you put percentage symbol, it won't run that file. Okay, it won't run. So this is my template. I am going to use this template. So in begin matter, okay, I'm going to use one by one. Yeah, front matter. I am using this certificate page or table of contents. Okay, so shall we start with first chapter in main content? Shall we start with first chapter? Okay, yes. Yes, I am using chapter. If you want to print chapter, I am using this command chapter. Okay, chapter name is introduction. Okay, this is my chapter. Okay, I am running this file, quick build. It gives the output. If it has no error, it gives the output. Yeah, it prints automatically. Okay, yeah, table of contents. First page is table of contents. So second page is, yeah, yesterday we I already told to you. In standard textbooks, chapters begins only in the right hand side. Right hand side means only add page. Okay, add page number. Front matter always prints the page number as a Roman letter. Okay, Roman letter. Yeah, just to see that. It prints page number 1, 2, and so on. Okay, it leaves second page as empty. Okay, because new chapter always starts with add page. Okay, just to see that list of figures. It's my second section. It prints only add page. That means right hand side page. Okay, that means right hand side page it is. Okay, so next one, list of tables. It comes because of that content already we have used here. Yeah, list of, yeah, this command. These things. List of table of contents prints our content. This content printed by this command, table of contents. Okay. List of figures printed this command. List of figures printed by this command. / list of figures, and also list of tables also printed by this command, list of table. So next one, chapter one. Okay, chapter one prints. Okay, so chapter one. In this chapter, we are going to see, and so on. So I am running this file just to see that. Yeah, in this chapter, it gives the output like this. Suppose if you are adding one section, okay, / section. That's also possible. It's my first section. I am running this file. First section content. Okay. First section content. So I am running this file. Yeah. It gives the output like this. Once again, I am running. I didn't prepare table of contents manually. It automatically gives the table of contents and also number. Chapter one, introduction. Okay, section, introduction, 1.1. Okay, this 1.1 denotes first chapter, first section. First chapter, first section. Just to see the table of contents. Yeah, table of contents. It automatically prints that. Okay, introduction. It appears in page number one. Section is also appears in page number one. I am using hyper reference package. That's why link will work here. Okay, I am pressing that link. It's my first section. It automatically goes that first section content. Okay. So I'm going to insert some other section. Suppose I'm using section, next section, I'm creating second section. Okay. I'm not expert in typing. So that's why mistakes happen. Second section. Okay. I'm preparing second section. Yeah. Just to see that it gives the output second section. Suppose if you don't want this number for this section, don't worry, just press star symbol, that won't print that number. Okay, yeah, it gives output like this. Okay, just to see the table of contents also. Yeah, it won't appear in table of contents also. Okay, if you are pressing star, it won't appear in table of contents also. So next one, we are going to see something else about how to prepare some second chapter and so on. Okay, so second chapter. Okay, second chapter. It's my second chapter. I am running this file. Yeah, it prints second chapter. Okay, just to see that page in main content. Before print matter, page number appears in Roman letter. Okay, Roman letter, but in our main matter. Now appears in Arabic number. Main matter appears in Arabic number 1, 2, 3. So always new chapter begins with right hand side. That means our page number. So second chapter begins in page number 3. Okay. So next we are going to something. Yeah, I am going to use one theorem. Yeah, command is begin theorem. Okay, I defined as theorem. THM means theorem. End theorem. It's environment. THM is environment. This is complementary command. Environment is always complementary command. I am preparing one theorem. Let X be a mathematical. Okay, it's a mathematical content. So let X be a non-empty set. Okay, non-empty set. Just to see that output. Okay. Yeah. Theorem 2.0.1. That means 2 is nothing but second chapter. 0 is section number. We didn't mention any of a section about that. Okay, 0 section, first theorem. Suppose if you are adding one more section here. Okay, section, first section in second chapter. Just to see that output, what will happen here? Yes, theorem 2.1.1. Okay, you don't bother about that numbers. It automatically gives the number. Second chapter, first section, first theorem. Let x be a non-empty set. Let me explain this command. New theorem style command. Yeah, just to see that side by side view. Yeah, new theorem style. THM for new theorem style. So baseline skip. This first base gives the space above the theorem. Okay, above the theorem. This much space is defined here. I am using baseline skips. That means default line space 2. This second base denotes the space below the theorem. Okay, below the theorem. Third one, slanting shape. This slanting shape denotes this one. The body content. Okay, body content. Let x be a non-empty set. It's a slanted shape. Okay, so it's defined from here itself. So next one, body font. Okay, next one, body font. Fourth content. Yeah, body font. Fifth one is intent space. Okay, space intent. This much space. It gives automatically one space between the body of content and the head. This much space after dot. Okay. So next one, BF series. This is nothing but body head. Okay. Sorry, head. Okay. This style, theorem style. Suppose if you remove this BF series, just I am going to show this much. Okay. I am removing that BF series. What will happen? Okay, just to see that output. Second chapter. Okay, it appears in second chapter. Yeah, just to see the difference. Okay, previously it appears in bold space. I am removing that bold space from here. That's why it appears like that. Okay, so it's not good. So that I am using that command BF series. Okay, so if I run this file, this command automatically prints that second chapter. Yeah. It bold face. Okay, so next one is this dot denotes the this dot punctuation mark. Suppose I don't want dot, I need semicolon. That's also possible. Okay, I made a semicolon. Just run this file. It will be output. Now second chapter, this one. Okay, before it appears dot, now it appears semicolon. Okay, that's also not good. So I am using dot also. Okay, so next one is this space. Okay, space between the above and the below contents. Okay. Next one we are going to see. So next, how to add some other things. That means suppose I am next, I am preparing one lemma. Okay, lemma LEM. Okay, LEM. I am prepared one lemma and end lemma. Okay, lemma. So this is my lemma. This is my lemma. Okay, so just to see that it gives the continuation number. Okay, yes. Yeah, lemma 2.1.2. It automatically gives the continuation number because of this command. This THM. Okay, this THM. This section. This section prints the section wise number. Section wise number 2. That means second chapter, first section, first theorem. This THM denotes the continuation number. Okay, optional bracket continuation number. Suppose if you are removing this THM, this optional bracket THM. What will happen? Just to see that it gives separate number. Okay, it gives separate number lemma 1. Okay, it gives separate number lemma 1. It's also not good. Suppose if you want to rename, that's also possible. But I am using continuation number. I need continuation number for that purpose. I am using this one. Okay. Yeah. Suppose if you want to reach change the content or change the order of this content. Okay, order of this content. So theorem appears first here, lemma appears second. Okay, in this order, theorem number is 2.1.1, lemma number is 2.1.2. Suppose I change the order of this content. I am copied here. Okay, now I run this file. So just to see that lemma number should be same, but content are different. Okay, lemma 2.1. So suppose if you are doing in Word, is it possible? Is it possible automatically? No, it's never. In Word, it's never. Suppose if one or two theorems means we may manage, we can manage. But suppose if you are preparing 100 theorems, your guide told theorem number 50 is no need for us. What will you do? We can delete in Word processor. We have to delete that theorem number 51, and then we have to renumbering the follow-up theorems. Theorem number 52 comes 51, 99 comes 98, 100 comes 99, like that. We have to do all these things manually, but we don't need bother about that. it automatically take care of that numbers, theorem, corollary, whatever it may be, it automatically take care of that number. Okay, that is the advantage of LaTeX. So next, how shall I cite reference and label? Okay, I am labeled this theorem. Okay, label, this is label key. Okay, label key, it's used for refer somewhere else. Refer somewhere else. I am using this command, label key THM 21. That denotes, it's so for your convenience, you may use in your own way. I am using this command like a label theorem 2, second chapter, first theorem. Okay, so I am going to refer somewhere else. Okay, refer somewhere else from the theorem. So I am going to refer 2.1. From the theorem 2.1, we get, okay, I'm giving this command, I'm using this label key. This is label key. Okay, this is label key. I referred this label key here. Okay, here now I am going to run this file. Quick build. Yeah, just to see that we have to run two times for reference. Okay. Theorem 2.1.2, it automatically take care of that. Okay. Suppose if you are deleting or removing this content, that's also won't affect. Okay. So next we are going to see how to add bibliography. Okay, that's a very tedious one. So anyway, I'm going to show. Yes. Next presentation session. Yeah. So suppose if you are convenient to this, it's okay. Or otherwise, if you want to Tamil about these things, it's also available in YouTube. Just to see that, click that link, it automatically goes to that YouTube link. Okay. So next one, bibliography. So what is that bibliography? Okay, we are going to see one by one. So we got that command slash intent. Okay, sorry, bib item. Bib item denotes the entry of bibliography. Okay. Yeah, wait a minute. Yeah, yes, this is identifier. This is identifier. Next one is citation key. We are going to refer this key. We are going to refer this key alone. So this is all we may use in simplest form without optional bracket, bib item, C key, citation key. And the bibliography starts with this command, this environment. This environment is used to denote the bibliography slash begin bibliography. This is environment to print the bibliography of our content. So I am giving, yeah, I need its presentation file. That's why it gives the like a book. Okay, if you are using in article or the book class, it gives the number, continuation number. Okay, so how shall I type? Okay, so just to see the slash bibliography, this number denotes the number of items you have to enter. Okay, that means number of 199 up to 9999 we may enter our bibliography items. Bib item. Okay, bib item. This is optional bracket. If you want to add, you may add. Otherwise, leave it. Aurora. Aurora 1989. It is the author name. It's the publication year. Okay. It's user friendly. You may use in some other way. That's also possible. Okay. Because I am using this way. Yes. Aurora JS. This one. It prints this one. Emphasize. Font is. Font style is emphasize. Class emphasize. Introduction to optimum design. Okay. It's like it's a slanting page. Slanting text. That's why I am using emphasize page. This is publisher, publication year. Okay, this is the process, but it's not good. Based on my point of view, it's not good. We got to use bib item. So we are going to see one by one next. So formation of BibTeX. So there are 21 citation key is there. 21 formation is there to produce for bibliography. Okay, so first one is citation key. Second one is address. Address is nothing but articles or journals or magazines likewise. Okay. So next we are going to see something, author name. Okay, prints the author name. So next one, yes, wait a minute, book title, chapter, or if you are using some chapters of book, that's also possible. So next one, edition, which edition you are using, editor, who is the editor of this book, institution. Suppose if you are attending conference paper, if you if you are using for reference purpose, conferencing paper, you have to use this also. And journal name, month, which month is published, note, organization, pages, how many pages are there, who is that publisher, title, volume number, year, publication year. Okay, it's 21 key is there to produce a good bibliography. Okay, so these things. Suppose if you are using article, suppose if you are using article, don't bother about that order. You may use you may type in any order, it will take the automatically take the formats. Okay, automatically take the format. That's not a matter. Okay. So next one. Yeah, this is the one example. At article, we have to prepare like this. At article, it's the citation key. It is the citation key. This is author name. Author is equal to, we have to enter in mandatory bracket. Author name, title, journal, volume number, number, pages from this to this. Pages, publication year. It prints like this. Okay. Yeah. So we are going to get, it's not possible. Okay. To prepare these things is not possible. Okay, so that I am going to show in easiest way how to download this BibTeX item from online source. Okay, that's very easiest way I am going to show you. Yes, just I am going to share my browser. Okay, yeah, just go to your Scholar, Google Scholar. We are going to get the BibTeX item from Google Scholar. Okay, Google Scholar. Okay, go to Google Scholar. Yeah, prepared one. I completed my PhD in fixed point theory. So that's why I'm using one paper from here. I want to refer some papers from fixed point theory. Okay, just listen carefully how to enter, how to make BIP item from online source. Okay, from here, just click this button. This is for citation. Okay, this notation is used for citation. Just see it. I am pressing this button. There's also a lot of formats available. ML, sorry. Yeah. Suppose if you are pressing this button, gives the MLA style, APA style, Chicago style, Harvard style, Panker, BibTeX, BibTeX, EndNote, Refman, RefWorks. Okay. We are interested only in BibTeX, so that just press that BibTeX button. Just wait a minute. It gives some other page. Yes. It gives automatically gives that content. Automatically gives that content. So I'm going to show. Yes. TechMaker is visible or not? Anyone, please? TechMaker. Yeah. Just I copied this content from online. I'm using one book. Okay, I'm using book. That's automatically generated key. If you want to change the citation key, you may change. Okay. Suppose I want to change this ref one. Okay, reference one, title, fixed point theory, author. We don't bother about that. Google Scholar gives all the related details in that format. BibTeX. Okay, just need that file. So I am using ref one. Just I am click build this button. Usually it won't appear. Yes, it gives some error. I think so. I will show you later. So usually, I will explain. It usually won't appear because we got to mention BIP item dot BIP file. We got to save this file as BIP file. Okay, and so on. After that, you got to run this method BibTeX. Okay, BibTeX is option is there. Okay, BibTeX. You got to run your tech file from BibTeX mode, LaTeX mode. Sorry, PDF LaTeX mode, BibTeX mode. Once again, PDF LaTeX mode. You got to run in this command. This file in you got to run four times. PDF LaTeX, BibTeX, PDF LaTeX, PDF LaTeX. Then only it gives the references. Okay, references. So I think we have completed our session. I think so. If you have any questions regarding that, you may post your question in chat box. Dear participants, if you have any question, you may post your questions here in chat box. Dear participants, if you have any question, you may post your questions here. So repeat the referencing process. Now we got to add references in two ways. First way is we got to add directly. Okay, we got to add directly. Second way is from the bib file. Okay, from the bib file. Bib file is generated. We may get this, but making bib file is too much complicated. Making bib file is too much complicated. So that we may get it from online source, from Google Scholar. From Google Scholar. Now once again, I will share my screen. Yes, Google Scholar. Whatever it may be your content. Suppose if you are familiar with the differential equation or somewhere else, some other topics. So suppose I want to get this paper. Okay. Differential equation related papers. Okay, differential equations. I want to get this paper. Yeah, stochastic differential equation. Suppose if you want to refer this journal, okay, refer this journal. Just click this quotation mark. It gives lot of formats. We are interested only in BibTeX format. Yeah, it gives in collection because it's available in collection. Okay, it gives the, it has lot of proceedings collection. Yeah, now is it visible? Yes, in collection. Okay, this article appears in collection only. In collection, its author name. This is the author name and the publication year. Its citation key we may change as per our wish. We may change this key. So next one, it gives the title. Author name, book title, and pages from 65 to 84. Okay, in collection. That means we are using some parts of that book. Some parts of that book. That's why it's in collection. Okay, some parts of that book. That pages 65 to 84. Published year 2014. Publisher. Just you copy this file from here itself, and then paste your BibTeX file. Okay, you got to run in TeXmaker with four command. First of all, you got to run this command in PDF let. PDF LaTeX, okay, PDF LaTeX, then BibTeX. So after this, you got to run PDF LaTeX. Once again, you got to run PDF LaTeX. Then only it will appear. Okay. So one more thing, if you are refer this reference or book or page in somewhere else, then only it appears. Otherwise, it won't appear. Suppose if you are having 1,000 references in your file. Suppose if you are having 1,000 references in your file. But your citation is only around 50 to 100, only 50 to 100. That much reference only appears in your content. The remaining references won't appear. Usually won't appear. So that's not a matter. Whenever you are citing, then only it appear. Otherwise, it won't appear. Okay. Regarding with this, any other question? If you have any other question, if you have any questions, please, you may post your questions in chat box. So my question, dear sir, is that once we have copied the collection, how it will be framed in our bibliography? Yes, sir, you got to. Yes, I will show. Here, I am using this.
Your audio
is not visible here. Is it audible?
Audio is not clear.
Audio is not clear. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Just I am showing one of my thesis. Yeah. Wait. I will show.
Certificate is received. So the name which I have given in the slide is full name. Certificate is received. So the name which I have given in the slide is full name.
Please, your voice is not hearable.
Audio is not clear.
Okay, now it's okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Dear participants, if you have any question, you may post your questions in chat box or otherwise. So, sir, you may proceed, sir.
Yes. Dear participants, if anybody have any questions or clarifications, you may ask now or post your questions in the Telegram group. So, thank you, participants, for your involvement and patience listening. And I hope so that session is clear and understandable. So, thank you. Thank you to everyone. And Dr. Sabha, thank you for your clear and understandable explanations. Thank you for all your efforts to make us understand everything. Thank you. So I hope so we can wind up the class. So thank you for everyone. Expecting your full participation tomorrow also. Thank you once again for all. Thank you.
Thanks to one and all.